introduce you to what the world has been waiting for. I've come to herald the arrival of a generation with the capacity to see God's dream become man's reality. Oh, can you see it? We are the ones who refuse to blend in or fade out. We can't stay hidden in the church, and we won't stay silent in the streets. The time for prophesying a soon coming generation of world changers has passed. That generation is here if we'll see it. And our time is now if we'll take it. Let me paint you a picture so you know who to look for. We value faith over fortune. We long for presence, not popularity. We'll take the kingdom over comfort, and we trust the gospel more than the government. There is something in our DNA that can't accept the status quo, business as usual, things as they are. We will never fit in the box marked normal. But you know what? We never really wanted to. We watched our parents and peers give their lives to a cultural system designed for our destruction. So our minds have been made up. We are persuaded and convinced that the freedom Christ promised is the freedom Christ purchased with his blood on that cross. So that cycle of broken people breaking people, it ends with us. With suicide, depression, sexual dysfunction, and substance addiction beckoning and threatening the destiny inside us that cries to be realized, we say no to moral degeneration. We say no to a world that pretends that sin is no big issue. Friend, sin is the only big issue. We say no to the idea of just fitting in to this broken system. The time for change is now. Let the world choose its own path, but let them know that we are the resistance. Let history show that there was a mighty generation that arose from the ashes of religion, from the broken cycle of humanism and cultural irrelevance, to take their place, seated and established as the new standard of righteousness in a culture that mocks purity. I see a generation that clings to the cross and not the culture. I said, I see a generation that clings to the cross and not the culture. The world is experiencing the revealing of a counterculture, a revolution of men and women with fire in their eyes and hope in their hearts, a peculiar people who love the hurting and proclaim the kingdom without consideration of the cost they might incur. We are social terrorists, shaking the foundations of the kingdom of darkness with radical consecration, public proclamation, and urgent intercession. And our peace and love are in violent opposition to the status quo. We should not, cannot, will not live another day in complacency. We are the leaders of a remnant, the keepers of the flame, the preservers of the seed, and the protectors of tomorrow. Heaven and earth together cry out for the manifesting of the sons of Yahweh. So we take up our courage, and we take up our cross. We fix our eyes on glory, and we let our lives proclaim his infinite work. We won't give an inch to the powers of darkness. We